In this lecture, we will talk about state space average model of DC to DC converters. We already have discussed some important points about the state space average modeling, in which we examine the state of the converter in on state and also off state. So in the previous class, I have explained that there are two possible models. The one is about state space model for the DC converter on the steady state conditions. So this is for the steady state condition. Okay. And second is that for dynamic model. So then we have a dynamic model here. Then we combine these two models, it becomes generalized model. So in this figure on the left hand side, you see generalized model. Okay, this is the combination of these two. You can see this is D cap here, this is D here. So this is combination of D and D cap. Similarly, this is X cap. So this is X plus X cap. The input is B in plus B in cap. Now, so this is B in plus B in cap. And then there is a B0 plus B0 cap on this side. And there is a I in cap on this side. So this becomes the generalized model, which is the combination of steady state and dynamic. This is combination of steady state and dynamic model. After that, we have tried to find out the average state. So what we did during on time and during off time, we have computed the state. So this is for on time, this is AX, so this should be A1. So during the on time, the state is X dot during on time, which can be written as A1X plus B1U plus M1I0 cap. I0 cap is the input, because for any change in the output, there should be change in the state. Similarly, for X during T off is A2X here plus B2I in plus M2 I0 cap. And this state exists for time D into T, because this is on period, this is off period. So we find out the average of this by multiplying the X dot by T on, and then X dot off into T off, divided by T on plus T off. So this average state therefore finally comes as X during T on into D, and then X during T off into 1 minus T. Then we substitute the value of XT on and XT off. So this is whole thing is XT on, this is XT off, in terms of the parameters or matrices A1, A2, B1, B2, M1, M2. So the average state is equal to A1 into D plus A2 into 1 minus D into X plus B1 into D plus B2 into 1 minus D into B in, and M1 into D plus M2 1 minus D into I0. Now we can expand, or we can linearize the X average dot about the state X for incremental change in X cap as X dot cap, for corresponding change in duty cycle as D cap. So these are the changes. So D becomes, in fact, D plus D cap. B in becomes B in plus B cap, because cap represents the change and this represents the steady state value. This is the change. It's like delta B, in fact, I should say. So we write as a B in cap. Corresponding change in the duty cycle is D plus D cap. This is the steady state value. This is the change in the duty cycle. This is the steady state value of state, and this is a change in the value of state. So with these incremental changes, we can expand the X average about steady state value of the state, that is x. So how it is done? Now we have to come back to the equation that we have developed for x average dot. So this is the x average dot, as you can see. Okay, now this x average dot is written as, from the previous discussion, a1 into d, then a2 into 1 minus d into x, plus b1 into d, plus b2 into 1 minus d into b in, and plus m1d plus m2 1 minus d into I0. Now in the further discussion, we will drop the notation bracket. For the sake of convenience of writing, we drop this bracket. And we assume that x is a column vector, a1 is a system matrix, b1 is the input matrix, and so on. So when we expand this x around x cap, using x cap, then x average dot is equal to x dot plus x dot cap. Okay, so for this change in the state from the previous state, we can say that x dot plus x dot cap is equal to x average dot. But we have to find out what are these values in terms of these parameters. So we replace on the right hand side d by d plus d cap for the change in d cap, and for the state x as x plus x cap. So x becomes x plus x cap, d becomes d plus d cap, and b in becomes b in plus b cap here. And then we simplify. Okay, so once we substitute the value of these variables in terms of the steady state value and the incremental value, and then we collect the coefficients of d and d cap, because we want to separate them as steady state duty cycle value and the incremental change in the duty cycle value. So we expand in d and d cap parts. So this becomes a1d, the first one is here. Okay, so a1 into d, this is a1 into d, plus a2 1 minus d, this one. So a2 into 1 minus d. Then plus a1 minus a2 into d cap. So this a1 here and this a2 into d cap. The minus sign is here. So a1 minus a2 into d cap. So a1 minus a2 into d cap. Then whole thing into x plus x cap. Right now, we did not change this variable. We only arrange this term in terms of d and d cap. So this is d cap part, this is d part. The same thing we do for the b in variable. So b in is here, this one, and this coefficient or this factor is being separated as d and d cap part. So obviously this is b1d plus b2 1 minus d. Okay, so this come as a b1d here, then this is here b1 into b2 into 1 minus d, this one. So this is b2 into 1 minus d plus b1 minus b2, this is b1 here minus b2 into d cap. So b1 minus b2 into d cap. Similarly, we express the last term as I0 cap, this one. So this comes here as such, and this we arrange in form of the d and d cap. So we get here m1d, the first one, from this, plus 1 minus d into m2, m2 into 1 minus d, this one, then plus m1 minus m2, m1 minus m2 into d cap, so this is m1 minus m2 into d cap, and the whole thing into I0 cap. So what was the step here? Separate these terms inside the bracket as a coefficient of d and d cap. After this, we will arrange these terms 1, 2, 3 in form of x and x cap, b in and b in cap, and I0. I0 won't have any steady state value. The steady state value of load current has no effect on the dynamic performance. Therefore, I0 is not considered. Alright, now we will arrange the above equation in form of the coefficients of x, x cap, d cap, b in cap, and I0 cap. So let us expand these terms. So first we expand x plus x cap. Okay, so x into the whole thing. So a1 d plus a2 1 minus d into x. So this is the first term. A1d plus a21 minus d into x. This is x. Then this term into x. This term into x. Because first I want to take x component. So x is the whole thing into x actually. So the a1 minus a2 into d cap. So plus a1 minus a2 into d cap. So x is common in both. But there is a d cap here. That's why I cannot combine this term with this term. Okay, so we don't combine these two terms because of d cap. Then the next one is in component, this component. So again, this is b1d plus b21 minus d. So b1d plus b21 minus d into b in cap. B in, this is b in. The next term is b1d plus b21 minus d into b in cap, because there are two terms, so this is b in cap. Same thing repeated. Then comes the term the d cap. So the next term is b1 minus b2 into d cap into b in cap. So this is the whole thing into b1 minus b2 into d cap into b in, this into this here, and then this into this, that is d cap into b in cap. There are four terms. So 1, 2, 3, 4 from this term. The last one is I0 term, this one. So I0 is as such, but now we can expand this term in form of the d and d cap term. So the first one is m1d plus m21 minus d into I0 cap. So this is the first one. Plus m1 minus m2 into d cap into I0 cap. This is the second one. So plus m1 minus m2 into d cap into I0 cap. These are the terms that we will get in terms of these parameters as a coefficient of x, x cap, d, d cap, b in, b cap, I0 cap. Now here is some simplification. What is that? The simplification is that the terms with d cap into x cap or d cap into b in cap and d cap into I0 cap, they are product of incremental changes in the duty cycle x or b in or I0. So they are the product of two small incremental changes. Therefore, they contribute negligible change in the state x plus x cap, and hence these are ignored. So which terms are ignored? This is ignored. Okay. This is ignored. This will not be considered. And this will not be considered. And this will not be considered. So these three are gone. Because of product of two small incremental changes, which contributes negligible to the whole term. So what are remaining terms? The remaining terms are the first one, a1d plus a21 minus d into x, the first one. The second one is the b1d plus b21 minus d into bn, because we want to arrange in the order of steady state values, then the incremental values. So this is x, steady state value, then there is a b in steady state value. Then comes the incremental changes. So the next one is this term, x cap, this one. So a1d plus a21 minus d into x cap. And then b in cap is here. Alright, so b in cap is here. This is b in cap, this is b in cap. This is x cap. This is x cap, okay, and this is b in, this is b in, this is b in, this is x, this is x. Four are done. Then there is a d cap. Now d cap term is present in two terms. One is this d cap here, other d caps come from this term d cap here. So these two terms, 1 and 2, becomes the coefficient of d cap. So if you add them together, it becomes a1 minus a2 into x plus b1 minus b2 into b in. So this is b in here term, b1 minus b2 into b in into d cap. And the last one is from the I0 cap. So I0 cap is this term only, so M1D plus M21 minus D into I0 cap. So this must be X average dot for this value of steady state and incremental change in X dot cap. And these are the right hand side expressions. So we can now find out what is X dot and what is X dot cap. So what must be the x? The x must be steady state value of the state. So obviously these are the steady state values. So this form the x dot, or simply x dot if I drop the bracket. And these are incremental changes. These are because of the incremental changes in the x or b in or d or I0. Therefore this whole thing must be x dot cap, and therefore x dot plus x cap becomes the x average dot. From this we have this equation for the following notations. Let us say a is equal to a1d plus a21 minus t. You can also call it a as the a average. But since it is already we are in the average model mode, so there is no need to write. But it's understood the A is actually A average. As you can see, this is A1 into D plus A2 into 1 minus T for steady state value of duty cycle T. Similarly, let us denote B as B1D plus B2 1 minus T. Let us denote M equal to M1D plus M21 minus D. And let us denote F equal to A1 minus A2 into X plus B1 minus B2 into Bn. So we substitute this notation back into this equation, we will get this equation. That is x dot plus x dot cap on the left hand side is equal to ax plus bu plus ax cap plus b in cap plus fd cap plus mi0 cap. And this must be obviously x dot cap. And this must be x dot. So now we have found the average state model in terms of the steady state values here and in terms of the incremental changes in the parameters of the converter, which accounts for change in the state value, and these account for the steady state value. In the steady state, if you look carefully, the x dot is always equal to zero, because the steady state values are constant for a given parameters of the converter, the load configurations. There is no change, there is no dx by dt or dx by dt equal to zero. Therefore, x dot is equal to zero. If I impose this condition on the equation, this, then we will get this equation as ax plus b in equal to zero. And this will give us ax equal to minus b into b in, finally gives us x equal to minus a inverse b in. So this is value of the state for which this condition is satisfied. This is from steady state condition of the converter. Now we have written the steady state equation for the converter. Let us focus on the output equations. Like we have a state equation, we have a output equations. So first you have to recall what are the outputs for the generalized model of the converter, V0 and IN. So V0 and IN are the output variables. While I0 is taken as the input variable, because for any change in the output, we must be able to regulate the voltage. So I0 acts as the input variable and IN is basically output variable. So like we can express the state, we can also express the output variables in form of these two equations. V0, let V0 be QX plus KU. As you know, the output is in a state vector, in a state space analysis, denoted by Y equal to CX plus DU, if you remember. Okay. So here it is simplified to two outputs. One is the V0 and the second is the IN. So V0 is equal to QX. So Q is equivalent to C actually. And K is equivalent to D. We have used some different notations, that's all. So V0 is equal to QX plus KU for some value of Q and K. And IN depends upon the state, that is X. So P into X. So these are two output equations for the DC to DC converters. Now we will follow the same procedure. First we will define the on state and then off state, and find out these outputs for on state and off state. And then we will take the average of these on and off state. The same procedure that we have done for finding the average state. Similarly, we will find the average output and average input current. So let us first focus on the average output voltage. Okay, so let us say for value of Q1 and K1, you can see from here, for Q1 and K1 there is a V0 during on condition. So V0 during on equal to Q1 into X plus K1 into I0 cap. Similarly, V0 during the off condition is V0 during off equal to, for some value of Q2 and K2, is K1 q2 into x plus k2 into i0. Now we can take the average of these two states. So what will be the average output voltage? V on into D plus V0 off into 1 minus D. Now we will simplify this and we will substitute the value of V0 during the on condition and during the off condition. So during on, we have expressed it as Q1 into X plus K1 into I0 cap into D plus Q2 into X during off condition, Q2 into X plus K2 into I0 cap into 1 minus D. Again, we collect in terms of the X and I0 cap. So then this X is common for this term Q1 into D here and then Q2 into 1 minus D. So this is Q2 into 1 minus D from this term. Then we collect the coefficient of I0 cap because these are the two inputs for these outputs. So I0 cap and X, they are inputs. So for I0 cap, we have the coefficient of, you can see from here, K1 into D, this K1 here into D, this one, plus K2, this one, into 1 minus D, this one. So K1D plus K2 1 minus D. These are coefficients for X and I0 cap. Now we expand around the value of V0 in terms of the V0 and V0 cap. So this V0 average, you can write like V0 average is now equal to V0 plus V0 cap for some incremental change in the V0 output voltage by replacing dy d plus d cap, x by x plus x cap, okay, and I0 is I0. So if we do this, then we will again arrange in terms of the d and d cap. So this becomes q1d plus q2 into 1 minus d into x, this into this, this into this, into this, plus q1 minus q2 into d cap, q1 minus q2 into d cap, this one d cap, also plus q1d plus q2 1 minus d into x cap, because there is x cap also, the whole thing into x cap. So this is q1d plus q2 1 minus d into x cap. And then the last term, q1 minus q2 into d cap into x cap. So this is q1 minus q2 into d cap into x cap. Then from this second term, we get two terms in terms of d and d cap. So this is k1d plus k2 1 minus d into i0 cap. And then k1 minus k2 into d cap into i0 cap. We will use the same logic that the multiplication of two terms which are incremental terms like this term and this term contribute a very small value for the whole term and therefore these two terms are negligible. So we ignore them. Let us assume that Q is equal to Q1D plus Q2 1 minus D and K is equal to K1D plus K2 1 minus D. Using these equivalence, we will find what is the V0 plus V0 cap. So V0 plus V0 cap, therefore this side can be written as Q into X, this is Q into X here. Then here it is Q into X cap, so Q into X cap. Then K into I0, this one K into I0, and q1 minus q2 into d cap. So it's q1 minus q2 into d cap, this one, into x. So x is coming here. Okay, x is coming before d because I am considering d as a variable. So for that variable, x is taken as a constant. And again, simplifying in terms of the steady state and the variable component, then we say definitely that b0 is equal to qx. So this is nothing but b0. This must be b0. And this must be v0 cap. Because this is the change in the output voltage. And this is the steady state value of the output. So therefore, v0 equal to q into x, and v0 cap is equal to qx cap plus ki0 cap plus q1 minus q2 into x into d cap. Fine? So this is the expression for the output variable. Likewise, we can express for the output variable I in cap. So for input current as output variable, please note the input current as output variable, we can write during switch on I1 equal to P1 into X, I in depends upon the state only, so P1 into X, during switch off it is I in into P2X. And therefore, I in average nothing but P1 into D plus P2 into 1 minus D. And therefore, this IN average can be expressed as IN plus IN cap, that is the steady state value and the incremental change around that, equal to P1 plus P2, P1 into X plus X cap, because X becomes X cap here, X plus X cap, D becomes D plus D cap, and again this is X, this is D. Okay, so we can expand this and find out what is its value. So we can write this equation in form of some parameter here, X plus some value here, X cap plus some coefficient here and D cap. So what is this parameter? This is nothing but P1D plus P2 1 minus D. So P1D plus P2 1 minus D. So this one also will be P1 into D plus P2 1 minus D. Okay? And then here you will get P1 minus P2 into X. There will be parameters X dot and D dot. These are ignored. Okay, so any coefficients of these parameters are ignored. This becomes form of basically PX plus PX cap, this is cap, plus P1 minus P2 into X into D cap. This is the state I in plus I in cap. So obviously this implies that what is I in? This implies that I in equal to PX. This is the steady state component. And I in cap equal to this one, P x cap plus P1 minus P2 into X into D cap. Okay, so these are two components of the steady state as well as dynamical change in the input current, which is considered as the output variable. Okay, now from this discussion, that is, we have basically input and output variables, and then we also have a state variable. We can find out the different gains for the converter, and based on these gains we can study the behavior of the converter, and which can be used for its design and the analysis. Alright, so we have established the relationship for various parameters such as x dot cap, as you can see from this equation, in terms of the x cap, b in cap, I zero cap, and similarly we have found the expression for the b zero cap in terms of the x cap, I zero cap, and we have the d cap, and for I in terms of the x cap and d cap. So with these three important parameters, change in the state, change in the output voltage, and change in the current, we can find out different gains or transfer functions. We can find out different gains and the transfer functions to study and analyze the behavior of the converter for the purpose of design and control. And these gains are described as following. The first one is B0 by B in. So B0 cap by B in. This ratio is called as RDO susceptibility. Then the next gain we define at B0 cap by I0 cap. This is called as output impedance. Next we have B0 cap by D cap. This is defined as the control gain. And then we also have I in by D cap. So this is I in cap by D cap. This is called the current gain. And we also have I in cap by B in cap, which is defined as the input admittance. So these gain characteristics we will study in the next class and see how these are utilized to design a particular converter to meet the requirements of the dynamic and the steady state characteristics.